Thomas's branch line is important, and so is Edward's. But you see, their tracks and bridges are not as strong as those on the main line. So that's why Sir Topham Hatt doesn't allow the heavier mainline engines like Gordon or Henry to run on them. But however, if you did hear Gordon talking a short while ago, you would have thought Sir Topham Hatt had given this order for quite another reason. "It's not fair," grumbled Gordon.
"What isn't fair?" asked Edward.
"Letting branch line diesels pull mainline trains."
"Don't worry, Gordon. I'm sure Boko will let you pull his car sometimes."
Gordon spluttered. "I won't pull Boko's dirty freight cars. I won't run on branch lines."
"Well, why not? It would be a nice change."
"Sir Topham Hatt would never approve," huffed Gordon. "Branch lines are vulgar." And Gordon steamed away.
Edward chuckled and followed him to the station.
Every evening, two fast trains always set off from Knapford Station. Gordon always leaves first with his express train for the main line, and then Edward follows 5 minutes later with his train for the branch line. It's usually a simple and easy routine. And most of the time, things always run like clockwork. But tonight, however, there was a little bit of a problem. And here is what happened. A lady in a green floppy hat was saying goodbye to one of her friends on Gordon's train, and it was nearly time for Gordon to leave. The fireman looked back toward the brake coach, and he saw something green waving.
"Right away, mate!"
He thought the conductor had waved his green flag, and so Gordon started, leaving passengers, luggage, and the conductor all stranded on the platform. Everyone was very confused, and very cross indeed. And then, to make matters even more worse, by the time Gordon was stopped and called back to the station, Edward was already late with his train. So this time, he set off first. But the signalman at the junction was not aware about the change. So by mistake, he sent Edward along the main line. Gordon was sent along the branch line, and he arrived cold and lonely on one of the sidings near the harbor. Next morning, Bill and Ben peeped into the yard. There weren't any cars for them, but they didn't mind that a bit. Teasing Gordon would be much better fun.
"What's that?" asked Bill.
"Shh," said Ben. "It's Gordon."
"Well, it looks like Gordon, but it can't be. Gordon never comes on the branch lines. He thinks of them as vulgar."
Gordon pretended he hadn't heard anything.
"If it isn't Gordon," said Ben, "it must be a lot of old iron, which we better take to the scrap yard."
"No, Bill, this lot is useless for scrap. We'll just take it to the harbor and dump it in the sea."
Gordon was alarmed.
"I am Gordon. Stop! Stop!"
When Boko arrived, Gordon thought of him as the best sight he had ever seen.
"Boko, my dear engine, save me!"
Boko quickly sized up the situation and threatened to take away the cars he had brought for Bill and Ben. This made the twins behave at once. Gordon thought Boko was amazing. "Those little demons, just how do you do it?"
"Ah, well," said Boko. "It's just a knack."
Gordon still believes to this day that Boko saved his life, but we know the twins were only teasing, don't we?
Thank you.